Hi everyone, welcome to Active Self-Protection Extra. We're here at C2 Tactical in Scottsdale. And today, I'm gonna make the Gunternet a little bit frustrated. And the way that I'm gonna make the Gunternet frustrated is by telling you that with your AR pattern rifle shooting 5.56, you're probably shouldering the gun wrong. I know, I just said that to be a little bit controversial, but here's what the reality is. I see a lot of people, and actually I put a post on my Instagram and on my Facebook page at Active Self Protection not too long ago with a brand new shooter that was shooting this rifle, and he had that rifle mounted up real high. He had it sitting way up like this, and a couple of people were like, you better teach him how to shoulder that rifle better, and you know what the right answer is? He was right, and they were wrong. Now, I'm gonna tell you where this stuff comes from and give you a little bit of history here, right? This comes from back, a couple things. Number one, hunting and our hunting rifle calibers. And number two, from our warfighters, but warfighters way back in the old country. My pop is a Vietnam Marine, right? So my pop, Norm McMahon, 3rd Recon Battalion, first full platoon on the ground in Vietnam and an actual snake-eating face shooter, okay? So like, dude is a real been there, done that. Hated the M16. You go talk to Vietnam Marines and a lot of them hate the M16. I think unnecessarily in a modern context, but that's another story. They're used to shooting the M14. M14 shooting 7.62, not shooting 223, not shooting 5.56. Before that, the guys that taught them how to shoot are shooting the M1 Garand, and the M1 Garand shoots 30-06. So obviously those cartridges have some kaboom, and when they got kaboom, this rifle's gonna move a lot. However, this guy here, they jokingly call it a poodle shooter, guys. Shooting 5.56, 223, it's the smallest rifle caliber cartridge that's out there. It has no recoil at all. This is why I love it when I see guys that are running this big old like muzzle brake on a 223. I'm like, you're running a muzzle brake on a 223? Good grief, man. What are you doing? Just making it loud for the people downrange, you know, on the side of you. So here's the thing. What we normally see with those other cartridges, with the other rifles, is you want it way down in here in the buttstock. You want that buttstock really buried underneath like this, because you really got to get behind this rifle to control the recoil. And of course, that makes you get down on the rifle to see your sights and really get in here. But guys, it's a 223. You don't need to do that. So guess what? I can bring the rifle up to my head, and as long as I have some contact here, all I need is just a little contact here. That's it. Just as simple as that. So let's watch the recoil on this. Again, I don't have very much here. Is the gun throwing me around? I'm not even doing anything to control the recoil. So I just brought the gun up there. I'm not even trying to control recoil here. So now let's think about this just a little bit. If I actually used a little push-pull here, notice that? Gun's not moving on me at all. So guess what, guys? You don't have to worry about burying a 5.56 stock. You don't really care. Bring the gun up to you and let the gun fire. You don't gotta worry about it with this. So I really think the better way here is, if I'm using the gun, it's time to shoot. And when it's time to shoot, it's time to shoot fast. It's time to shoot accurately. And that means to me, bring the gun up here and don't worry about burying the stock in your shoulder.